What's up, you guys?
I so don't know how to give an intro.
Clearly, I don't know how to do this, so. I don't know how to do this. I know the title is a little misleading, but blame her, not me. How to get... But I did get a sponsorship. Not now, but when I was that kid who used to eat mud. Someone looked at me and went, "You kid, noodles for a hair. I'ma educate you." And I said, "Sherry uncle." Now, I'm here doing my PhD. Instead, we married after some guy who's 15 years older than I am with 3 kids by now and the 4th one in my uterus. Yeah, so we're lucky. I'm lucky. I'm grateful. Now, did y'all know that the literacy rate in India in 2020 is 77.7%? Did y'all know that? I bet. Yeah, then. I'm like, what? 77.7%? That's a lot. I don't have to do anything. Yeah. No. That means 22.3% of people don't even know how to read and write, bro. What? And did you also know that the literacy rate increased only 6% in the last 10 years? What? First off, let's define what literacy rate means. It means anybody who can read and write. That means if you're a 12-year-old kid and you drop out of school, but you know how to read and write, you're considered literate. That means you don't have a high school degree, you don't have a bachelor's, nothing. You're still considered literate. How are you expected to grow out of poverty with just reading and writing in 2020? If you were somebody who could just read and write without a school degree and going and searching for a job, you're not gonna get one, bro. What kind of a job do you think is going to pay them well? Not many. And what kind of growth do you think that they are gonna have in that job? Not much. It becomes a cycle. Now, you can break it. You cannot grow out of poverty if your income is like this. Especially when the market is going like this. As the market goes like this, your income also should go like this. If it's like this, then you stay in poverty. And we are trying to bring their salary up like this by educating them. We must help each other, kids. Yes. So anyway, let me just talk to you all about child sponsorship. Child sponsorship, huh? Yep. So a lot of people go, does it even work? Nobody says it like that. Nobody cares what you think. Can you please get lost? Anyway. So a lot of people will be like, sponsorship, does it even get kids? Does that even help kids?
It does.
There are a few research papers that have been written. Links of those research papers are in the description below. And it says that it does positively impact a family. Tells that when a family cannot educate their kids, they feel a sense of hopelessness, and sponsorship brings a sense of hope into those families. Now, do you want to deny a sense of hope to those families? Do you? Huh? Do you? No, you don't. It helps you in finding a job of your choosing instead of the job choosing you. That's something that will help you tremendously mentally, I think, because we're all struggling to find the right job, especially when people, some of us, don't know what we should be doing in our life. And I think education is one way of trying to figure out what you want to do. And people who don't get these educations don't have a way of figuring out what they want to do in life. And society just puts these jobs that they have to do regardless of whether they want to do it or not, which is not right. And I feel like, I mean, we have the means, bro. Like, we're getting enough paid, bro. If you're sitting here and watching my videos, then I'm sure you can spare at least 100 rupees, okay? Donate it. Sponsor a kid. Buy that kid a phone. Download Coursera or any other like teaching apps or something. Give that to the kid. Teach the parents how to read and write. Oof, got a little emotional there. But do sponsor. There are organizations like Asha for Education, Shanti India, links in the description below. Yeah, those are the only two that I've come across, or at least I did not research as well. And I'm trying to donate or sponsor a kid in one of those organizations because I cannot afford to sponsor two. Okay, don't judge me. Unless you want to share this video and then ask them to subscribe and like, and then I get more cha-ching. I'm a sponsor only one because that's all I can afford. And then you'll have questions like, we only 10,000 rupees a month and you want us to sponsor on top of that. Who will take care of our parents? Don't sponsor them. Share this video, make a lot of people like it, subscribe it. From the money that I get, I'll sponsor 2 children. Or donate. You're gonna go to heaven. Yeah, heaven. Also, when you're looking into the sponsorship organization, make sure that you're looking into their administrative cost, how popular they are, how much work they've done so far. You can also sponsor based on the kid's ethnicity, his religion, his region. So you can like, I don't want to sponsor a kid in Cambodia. I want to sponsor a kid in India. Yeah, you have a lot of other choices too. But search, find out, sponsor one kid at least. You don't have to be a mother or a father to want to sponsor for a kid. You can just do it right now. Say it. I said it. So go do it. I'll probably be doing that very soon and I'll be posting that on Instagram. I'll also tell you why you need to do this. Because when the majority people are educated with degrees in their hand, more investors come to your country. And that's what we need right now. We need more people to come to our country rather than be flocking to a different country. And this coming from the girl who's doing her PhD in the USA. Yes, yes, I came here to realize all of this. So, but regardless, you know, if your main goal is to uplift your country or not, one should help each other and one should help poor at least get an education. So kids, go sponsor a kid.
Got a little emotional there and got a little carried away, but
sponsor, you know, donate. Give that child a chance. Give me a chance. I could have been that kid that uncle took a chance on and now I'm here. Start from the bottom, now we're here. Now you'll be like, sponsor. You have to sponsor me for the food that I can't afford myself. There are a lot of other ways in which people can be educated right now and they're not aware of it. We need to educate them and tell them, see, there is an application like Coursera. You can learn from it. Thanks you guys for watching. I hope you guys go sponsor a kid. Please go, pretty please. Okay, bye. Clearly, I don't know how to do this, so clearly, I don't know how to do this. Do, 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 do. I'm sure people from the outside can see me dance like a moron, but it's okay. Who am I here to impress, huh? Nobody. That's what. 7-year-old kid. When you're a 7-year-old kid, which standard are you in? You're 15 when you pass out of 10th, so 15, 14, 12. So if you're like a, those are the only twos that I, only twos. Is 77.7%, 77 point, a sudden slip of my Malu slang just came out, but. The sun is finally shining down on us. So go there and educate them however you can, because it's necessary. And I wouldn't be here talking to y'all if somebody hadn't done that for me. If somebody hadn't stepped out of the house and decided to educate me. Woo! Got a little emotional there. Do that. Okay, go sponsor and educate kid. Because it's necessary for our country's development. There's no point in just bringing ourselves up if you don't have anybody next to you when you reach the top.